We have an update now to our top story. A massive destructive wildfire burning tonight in eastern New Mexico. Sky Ranger is flying live over the burn area right now. You can see a burned out house there. The tire fire began between Floyd and Melrose early this afternoon because of a vehicle's blown out tire. Sparks from the wheel ignited the nearby grassland. The flames have already burned three homes. You see one of them there, and about 4,000 acres. It has since spread east toward Clovis. We are following the story closely. We'll have the latest in our later newscast. And the wind was really blowing out there today.
Yeah, and we had 30-plus mile-per-hour gusts. And he's saying, well, that doesn't sound that bad. But when a fire is involved, it can really push in. That's exactly what it did. Pushed it right to the east. Most of the winds have been coming out of the west. Let's take a look at current wind speeds. We're at 28-mile-per-hour winds in Clovis. That's pretty close to the region that we are concerned about. Now, we will start to see these winds die down once the sun does set. But that does not mean we're out of the woods. Because as you can see at the warning map, a red flag warning, that is until 9 p.m. Tuesday. So that means our winds are going to pick up tomorrow even worse than we saw today, and we're not going to get any moisture, so that's not going to help us at all. So we're going to set up another strong wind system coming in for us as we get into Monday. Let's get back to that. I skipped over that slide, and I do need that. There we go. So taking a look at our winds for tomorrow, what you can expect is more fire danger, extreme fire danger in this area you see in red. These are where we will see some of our strongest winds. Our fire right now is right in this region, and we can expect possibly 65-plus mile-per-hour gust winds out of this thing, and that could be devastating when it does come to fire danger. This storm will also bring a chance for some precipitation, but it's going to stay so far north it'll be no help to anyone down in the southern part of the state, and what we do get will be meager at best. Maybe a thunderstorm in Durango and Farmington and some high mountain snow. We're talking the peaks of the San Juans, and even that would be an inch or so. So just like all the storms we've seen, they're going to stay far to our north. Now, the winds do relax by Tuesday, except for this area. It'll still be very windy, so critical fire conditions as we get into Tuesday. Get into more of a westerly zonal flow, as we call it, which is kind of a calm pattern for us. We do like this, so a mild Wednesday. But then again on Thursday, the winds are going to pick up. So it's going to be similar to what we saw, or we will see on Monday. So Thursday, we're going to have to keep an eye in this region as well for extreme elevated fire danger. Not a lot of cloud cover to work with here. We do see all the precipitation staying far to our north, trying to sneak into the state, but not much expected. And even if we do see rain tomorrow in the north and the northwest, you may have moisture in the upper levels, but we've been so dry in the lower levels that as it starts to fall, it just evaporates before it even hits the ground. So those are the things we have to deal with right now. In Albuquerque, 82 is the temperature. Winds are west, northwest at 20 miles per hour. We could see a 40-mile-per-hour gust tomorrow in the metro, but we won't really be the focus of the strong winds. Temperatures around the area, very warm. 94 in Carlsbad, 90 in Roswell. We won't falter too much from these temps tomorrow, and that's bad news when it does come to fire weather. Let's do the numbers. Northwest New Mexico, this is what you can expect. Partly cloudy, windy, an isolated rain shower Monday into Tuesday. Durango and areas north into Colorado have the best shot for rain out of this thing for Monday and Tuesday. A clap of thunder isn't out of the question either in Durango. We get a break on Wednesday and then some slight rain chances for Thursday and Friday. Farmington, Tuesday would be your best bet, but it's not looking all that great for rain in that area. 75 in Silver City, 88 in Las Cruces. Could see 45-mile-per-hour gusts for tomorrow in the southwest. Also concerned about fire danger. Silver City has been a very active area this season, so let's keep that in mind. We'll see temperatures starting to relax as we get into Wednesday and Thursday. Thursday will be another windy day for us, so we'll have to keep that in mind. Southeast New Mexico, this is our hot spot right now. So tomorrow, windy, high fire danger, 20-30-mile-per-hour sustained winds with gusts up to 45 miles per hour. The further north and east you head, the worse it gets. Warm as well. 92 in Carlsbad, 91 in Roswell. Starting to calm down with the temperatures as we get into the middle of the week. No rain on tap for the southeastern part of the state for this week. Northeast New Mexico, very windy. Could see 55-plus, 60-mile-per-hour winds, especially Santa Rosa, Klein's Corner, Tucumcari. We're going to really have to keep an eye on those areas for wildfires. 90 degrees in Tucumcari, 86 in Santa Rosa, mid-70s in Las Vegas. A windy day in Las Vegas for you tomorrow. A meager chance at squeaking out some rain Thursday into Friday in the northern mountains. Expect windy conditions, partly sunny. Temperature's not all that bad, but it will get breezy, especially windy, excuse me, along the mountaintop. 7-day forecast in Santa Fe shows a high of 75, a shot at rain on Tuesday, although it is a very slight chance. As we look at the East Mountains, it's going to be another very windy area tomorrow. High fire danger, could see 45-mile-per-hour gusts over in the metro. Windy, not as bad in some areas, but still you will notice a big uptick in the winds. Could see gusts up to 45 miles per hour, 40 miles per hour, and then we'll start to see temperatures relax as we get into the middle of the week, and then Thursday, another windy day here in Albuquerque.
Okay, thank you, Ian. Here's a look at tonight's primetime.